Hi students, this is Alex here. In this video, we are going to solve integration problem by partial fraction. So the given question is integral 2x by x square plus 1 into x square plus 2 whole square dx. Now we have to give substitution. Let t equal to x square. From this, dt equal to 2x dx, and we find 2x dx in the numerator. So our question will become integral dt by t plus 1 into t plus 2 whole square. We find repeated factor. For repeated factor, we discussed the partial fraction rule in the previous video. That is, when you have x minus a whole square, it will be a by x minus a plus b by x minus a whole square. This is the form we follow. Now let's copy the expression without the integration, which is 1 by t plus 1 into t plus 2 whole square. And first factor is single factor, so we write a by t plus 1. Second factor is a repeated factor, we follow the rule. So we have to write constant by t plus 2 plus another constant c by t plus 2 whole square. Now we have to take LCM. In the LCM part, we have t plus 1 into, here this is power 1 and this is power 2. In the LCM part, we take the highest power. So t plus 2 whole square. So when this entire term is multiplied by LCM, t plus 1 get cancelled. So a into t plus 2 whole square will come, plus b into, when I multiply, 1t plus 2 will get cancelled, so remaining will be t plus 1 into t plus 2 and plus c into t plus 1. And both the sides we find the same denominator, so we are going to equate the numerator. So 1 equal to this entire term, so 1 equal to a into t plus 2 whole square plus b into t plus 1 into t plus 2 plus c into t plus 1. Now to find the value of a, b and c, we take arbitrary value for t so that some terms get 0. When t is minus 2, this will become 1 equal to, since there is a factor t plus 1, this will become 0. Here also t plus 2, there is a factor. So first two terms will become 0. We left with only c into minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. From this, the value of c is minus 1. In the same way, when t is minus 1, then 1 equal to, when I put minus 1, we get a into, minus 1 plus 2 is 1, so 1 square is 1. So we have only a, and here t plus 1 is there, so it becomes 0. So the value of a is 1. So till now, we got the value of c and a. Now, as a next part, we have to take some value for t, but no term will become 0. So we are going to do the comparison of coefficients. So let's take the coefficient of t square on both the sides. So equating coefficient of t square on both sides. So here we don't have t square term, so 0. When I expand this, we get t square. So the coefficient is a. In the same way, when we expand this, we get t square. The coefficient is b. So when a plus b equal to 0. And last term, there is no t square. And by substituting the value of a here, we get the value of b. Therefore, b equal to minus 1. So we got three values. All these three we have to substitute in the term where we applied the partial fraction. So a by t plus 1. So integral 1 by t plus 1 dt. Then plus integral b is minus 1. So minus 1 by t plus 2. Minus 1 by t plus 2 dt plus integral c is minus 1, so minus 1 by t plus 2 whole square. So minus 1 by t plus 2 whole square dt. Now each term we are going to integrate. The first term is log mod t plus 1, second term is minus log mod t plus 2. An integration of 1 by x square is minus 1 by x. So using this, if I integrate this, already there is a minus sign, so now it becomes plus 1 by t plus 2 plus c. And the value of t is x square. That is the substitution we are given. We have to replace it here. So log of x square plus 1 minus log of x square plus 2 plus 1 by x square plus 2 plus c. So first two terms, it is possible to combine using the log rule. So log a minus log b is log a by b. So log x square plus 1 by x square plus 2. So we can take a modulus. Then the other term is 1 by x square plus 2 then plus c.